Okay. We have Tethys. Up against Dazed Talos. Shield Fell. Seraph the Impatient. Two Flash Freezes. Two Wicklashes. They'll probably not get used. And a Preserve. We have Dregs. Okay. We could talk about Token of a Traitor, but I'm going to pick Cuddlebeard. It's pretty good early. Random 2 damage, it's already better than Plink. Chill Wind?
Yeah, let's go.
I had Token of a Traitor actively hurting me fairly recently. I can't remember the scenario though. I think I had Cold Guard. So I was incanting because I needed to raise his shards. But the token was hitting 2 health minions and killing them. But I needed them to hit Cold Guard to trigger revenge. Versus those guys who get stronger every time they take damage. There's only one of those. Circle 7 boss. I'm gonna take this. I want the gold. And the guys in the middle floor only do 4 damage. The guys at the top floor do the most. We should be able to take care of some of them. One of them. Oh, look at that. Got used.
Dead.
Take silence straight away against idiot Seraph. Sakuraz can get rid of the dead weights. That's the best case scenario, is you put in a third card that in your deck that's not really doing anything, with the hopes that it removes 2 other cards so that then you're in front. And you can also get rid of Stuarts and other things as well, I guess, along the way. I think that's pretty important. Getting rid of Stuarts in early fights where you want to be playing offensive cards, but you want to be thinning, like removing Stuarts so you can cycle through better. Quick burnout in camp armor. I could also lady with it and put a drag, a draft behind, the draft we make behind her. Go for molding, no. On healing. Healing. Oh. There's also the money guy. Money guy's good. Hit incant with her. Silver Tear, thank you for continuing your gift sub from Wagner. Appreciate it, dude. Glad you're enjoying the show. What if we incant armor her? Is it enough? Maybe. Maybe if we get another one of those. And she starts getting four armor a spell. It's a little soft, but it's a possibility. I don't think multi is what we want. I wonder if this is a trap. Every time I go down the... Oh, we make drafts. Route, and we go and we have a multi-strike behind someone like her. The issue is that there's no priority. I mean, she is. But no, your DPS isn't. Although we Tethys. And then we do this. I mean, this seems pretty reasonable. Remember to cast spells just for incant, if not anything else. The winning double incant relic. Flash freeze. Kind of do. It's a decent amount of damage. Pellet dripping, strip fall. We can even go We could party lane-ish. Tough call. Like, that becomes a lot of healing. But extra unit slots could be a lot of upgrades. Oh, if we're drafting, it's not. Okay. Abandoned stave. Yeah. So, 5 energy. We can just take draw and draw. Play the... We can consume those cards with Sacres. And we still have the energy. We need to set up either top or bottom here. Yeah. Is that the haste units? And I wonder if setting up bottom is too much. Stun one and get. Could ignore the drip fall. Don't try to get many things in. Okay. But the draft dies because she wouldn't get hit. So the other option is mid. Have her get hit. No, we can't go mid. It's just. Huh. We can. We just take some damage, but if we're going to be healing, can we avoid it? Okay. Let's do it. Set up mid and plan to just heal our way through. Oh, it doesn't. When a consume card is played. Oh, we might be screwed. Put Stuart tank the bottom. Yeah, we could have saved some health that way. We wouldn't have been able to get a draft in. We might still be able to take out some of the hasters. Okay, so this we learn. Oh, I could have blocked. I had a spot open as well. Morning Spark, for God's sake. I was certain Reflective Lens healed when you consume those cards. I'm guessing it doesn't. The words there are quite clear. But... I need to save her health more than... Not too bad. Could have been a lot worse. Oh man, we could have got a really big draft off. Just have to go for a little draft. Intent on death. We don't have anything that we intend on dying. Endless on Tethys or Lady. Have you ever taken intent on death for a future something? A Stygian banner, so probably not. From Legion from Fel? Probably not. It's not bad though. Can you get Legion from Fel? You can get Bounty Stalker. Gift for guard so I can use lens. Yeah, I mean, it's a thing. It's a thing. Probably not, though. Come on, endless though, we can elevator. Seems okay. Oh, Wicklash Baron. We're good. Take draw. We have energy. We'll get a bigger consume card, maybe. Space isn't too much of an issue. Yeah, the extra unit slots looking really good now, though. Take sweep. Let me put that behind the draft, I think. I'll put the draft behind Tethys. So the sweep goes in first. Shame about the... Oh, it kills any little backliney things. I think. Yeah. No. I'd like to take that. But if we don't get a strong unit out straight away, there's problems. So we kill it with a draft, but I was kill it with a drag, but I want a draft. the start of the run, I was like, Wicklash isn't going to get used. And now it's doing great. We put on Tethys for more sweep behind her. Interesting combination. Actually good. Hey Methos, how you doing? Is there any point in freezing dead weight? Yeah, then you don't draw it again. If the game was, you draw to a max hand size type of game, then no, you probably don't want to do that, because you want to be drawing a fresh card instead of a dead weight. But in a game where you draw a specific number of cards up to a potential max hand size and you're not going to hit that max hand size, yeah, removing the chance of drawing a bad card again just by holding onto it's a really good thing to do. Yeah, then later it becomes an extra card for sac res. The only thing really on this side is cavern, which, you know, not bad, but... And by removing the Stuarts, we are removing sac res cards. But that's kind of okay, I guess. It's better than drawing Stuart. So it comes down to the dupe now. Just take another Endless. Take another Silence. Wow, this is... the deck is going to be pretty lean. And the Sacres is going to do that as well. So we'll have like flash freezes going through. They're just not strong enough to kill off the Shadewing, so we're going to need to get like plus 10s on them. Yeah, I'm thinking about the Silence now, because... For that exact reason, we want to get one really, really early against Seraph, because we're going to be hopefully spamming some spells. We're going to need to, just because of Shade Wings, or we're going to need to get plus 10s on, or a, you know, a spell power artifact. Crystal Cloak. This is reason to be. I think we can set up on top even with Tethys. Like a lot of times, things are just going to get killed. I'm not going to take the trial. We've got gold, but just for Crystal Cloak, we're going to need to bank up extra armor, and we might need to use some dregs along the way. So this one's going to be iffy because we don't want to. We don't want to be getting rid of our dregs. We're going to want to use them to try and bait out some some turns there. However, gonna make draw awkward. Glory Moon. Let's do like this. Panz. Draft dies, Panz. Brain issue there. Let's get one of these in. No, we don't have any reform. I'm gonna let that hit, just to keep burnout. We're not gonna be able to pull stealth stacks off this way. And they both burn out one, so it doesn't even help. You can silence the boss. It doesn't remove stealth, though, because it's it requires a purge. Okay, we're going to have a lot of frost on. It's not going to be, hopefully, not too bad. It's not great. Three sap. Yeah, that's the water bottle. Or whatever. It looks like a, yeah, like a chemistry one with the ball on the bottom. So it's a 50%. There's also the 50% chance to silence, but that's used for the dark purple buffs. The green ones, yeah, purge. There's no card that does that, is it? It's just the, it's only that relic. No, there is. Wickless recruitment. Removes all statuses and things. Okay, so the reform was only good for that one thing. I'm not going to start building into reform. I don't think any there's any other cards that, that do it either. I have no X cost. The Stygian ones are pretty good. Extra spells seems unnecessary, like our spells are so cheap. I'll take that in case we get the Stygian spike, because it is good. Hold over. Alright, plus 10 magic power on a flash freeze. I guess we're going to be holding over the flash freeze. Holding over Wicklash. I do have a lot of money. Permafreeze the sacres. Yeah, I was wondering about that. Or Dripfall? Dripfall's better. Probably not. If I set up top, I can save it for when there are units up top, so we won't die. I don't really want to be setting up top in the long run, though. And then if you're dripfalling units, then you're just pushing them down into other waves, so it's going to get worse and worse for you. On the Sacres is good because then we can use it when it suits us, and once we've done, once we have used it, we don't have to use it again. Like it just sits there. It has to be worth it with how much money you have, but there's the game's not over. This is not the last fight, so there's more things to come we could spend money on. So, I could have bought twice. So that's dead. That's... And getting frosted all the way up, jerk. Okay. Standing there. Doesn't even kill it. Bids is pretty strong. Like 400 damage a turn. If we get an early silence on Seraph, 20 damage, same as Fel. In the last 10 turns. With endlesses on the... Yeah, okay. It's going to be surviving the waves. It's going to be the tough thing. Easy spike with Hell Pact. Just draw. Go artifact. Plus magic power. We need to hit two of those, and then shade wings go down to a thing. Like, killing the shade wings is probably the most important. We do get one more merchant magic, so if we get plus 10s, it's not as bad. But having these kill shade wings, if we don't get the plus 10s. Sweepers. Pie wings have to be. We can't take the plus stack. Pie wings. Okay. This is okay. How many pyre wings are there? Is it just the two? There's three. So, yeah, I think we have to, and it sucks, but you know what you do. I mean, she might not, but then it's okay. Uh-oh. Panz. I need to go there and there. That does means we're not getting hit, which means we're not getting thing. Yeah, that's an oops. That's a big oops. For a drip fall. Save the day. That's going to be terrible. Should have Wicklash to draft? No. She's got trample. Double frost would have been good there, except you got to have the double frost for the whole fight. You don't use it all that often. We're fine. I just want to get that silence pretty much straight away. Play that though. Double endless. Yeah, me too. I thought it was over. We want two endless. About that, like I'm probably there, right? Yeah, maybe, because I'm more likely going to be just, oh yeah, I want that, man. So just used all my money. Yeah, I want that, and then I'll take this. I'm probably going to just be using that on a shade wing. No, I won't, because it's not an instant kill. What's more damage then? Biggest sap on idiot, and it's frost on idiot straight away. And that gives attack to Tethys and drafts and things. I think you probably got either one there. With that endless. Okay. Silence Tome, turn one. So the only question is, do we want to put this on idiot straight away? Or not? I think the answer is not, right? Oh, melee weakness is gonna suck. It's not the holdover one. So I'm so glad we got that. Good. If I put the Dreg in front, Dreg takes 10, we've got melee weakness on 15, so we take 30. If I don't put the Dreg in front, we take 20 from the melee weakness and 15, which is 35. That's how powerful melee weakness is. So it's only 5 health loss to do this, which then means we can possibly kill a Lightwing up top or a Soaker thing. Like, melee weakness is just so tough. Yeah, that's the other thing too. It doesn't, like, it's just a thing. It's not a status. Like, whereas Talos is not back and Daze becomes a silenceable thing. And it's one of many inconsistencies throughout the game that it's an annoyance. It's definitely an annoyance, right? But what can you do? I think we let this... Well, hang on. It comes down to whether we think Frost is going to be the key here. On 20 health, we want to be above 80, like 81 or above, for an extra Frost tick. So that takes one. And then it comes down to, do we chump here? What's next in the wave? Why is Twitch's sad face crying? Because sad crying is linked with emotional sad. Like, that's what sad people do, is they cry. I think more of a frown, not happy, but not crying. I mean, that's just unhappy. I guess sad's different. I guess the real thing is, does it really matter? Does it confuse you as if a, you know, sad face was smiling would be something to be confused about, but sad face crying's kind of understandable? Okay, if I drip fall this guy, nice. Okay. I do actually want to die here, not get armor. It doesn't matter. Let's just do this here. Get rid of that unit. It's fine. Get to play her on full health. No melee weakness. Melee weakness goes on the 6 hit point unit, which is great. Wicklash. Get rid of a vengeful shard. You can die. Draft lives. Hey, Banger. Goes really well, man. Finished the unexpected journey. It was good. Ben just had a win. It was good. It was good. Nothing special, Tethys being Tethys. This turned out to be... it was okay. Definitely didn't do what I thought it was going to do. The mechanic didn't work that way, but kept us healthy in some points. Silence applied, 26. Previous best, 25.